Okay, so probably this is going to be the last session as far as the finance functions are concerned in Excel, and then we would also have a very brief introduction about the sources of finance. Okay, let's move ahead, sharing my screen with all of you, and here we are in that finance function Excel file. I'm there into a worksheet of PPMT IPM. Now, individual applications of PPMT and IPMT, you people have already understood while preparing the loan amortization schedule. Sir, if we have already done it, then what's the need of it doing it now? There's a need because right now we're doing cumulative IPMT and cumulative PPMT. Some people will be like, huh? They couldn't understand this. That's okay. I'm going to explain that to you. Say, if I ask you a very simple question, you people are aware about one fact that the installment amount of the loan remains the same in all the number of periods in which we are going to pay the installments, right? That is point number one. You people have come to know that the principal amount and interest amount keeps on getting changed in the installment amount. So installment amount was, sir, basically the addition of the principal repayment and the interest amount. In the initial years, the portion of interest amount is always higher and the principal repayment portion would be smaller. By the time, the interest payment will keep on getting reduced, and my friends, the principal repayment amount will keep on getting increased. So I can say both have the inverse relationship. In earlier periods, you have the higher interest amount. So that's why we listen from relatives and some of the people who already in the loans that in the initial periods, the loan amount is not deducted at all. Yes, they are right. In the initial periods, the loan repayment amount is not deducted at all because you have the quite a good amount of outstanding balance, my friends. And on that outstanding balance, first the interest amount should be paid, and then remaining amount would be allocated to the principal repayment. Now, if I ask you one question, that there are 20 years as per this question only, loan amount is 1 crore, and 8% is the interest rate. What will be the interest in the first 5 years you will be paying? And what will be the principal repayment amount you will be paying in the first 5 years? Now, I am asking the cumulative total amount, my friend. I am not asking you to prepare the entire loan amortization schedule again. Now, if you'll be preparing the loan amortization schedule again entirely, then it will be a quite a time-consuming task, right? And we do not want to indulge ourselves into such kind of the mechanical exercises. There is a function called cumulative IPMT and cumulative PPMT, which tells us that what is the amount we have paid in the loan cumulatively for the number of periods, whatever the number of periods for which we want to get the answer for the interest as well as for the principal. Okay. जैसे करेंगे ना वैसे वैसे और मजा आएगा. तो हम जाते हैं पीपीएमटी आईपीएमटी वाले वर्कशीट में. वी हैव गॉट अमोर्टाइज लोन अमाउंट विच इज 1 लाख रुपीस, देन इंटरेस्ट इज 12%, नंबर ऑफ इयर्स आर 12. नाउ लेट्स अज्यूम वी वुड बी डूइंग द आईपीएमटी एंड पीपीएमटी फर्स्ट एंड देन वी विल गो टू द क्यूमुलेटिव आईपीएमटी एंड द क्यूमुलेटिव पीपीएमटी. सो द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ बोथ वुड बी क्रिस्टल क्लियर. So in the first instance, we have got, if you have anything else, you will be just deleting those things. First, it's a interest is, we want to find the interest for the 12th period. And the compounding is happening on a yearly basis. That means the installment is paid on a yearly basis. And we want to know that what will be the amount of interest for 12th year. If someone asks you that directly, then you should not be preparing the loan amortization schedule again entirely. You can start with the sign of equal to over here. Then use IPMT. And the first argument is the rate. I'm writing the rate over there, 8%, comma. Then per, PER stands for the period. For which period we want the interest amount? We want it for 12th period. So I'm writing 12, right? Comma. NPER stands for the total number of periods in a year, my friends. That's going to be anyway 12. So I'm writing 12 there, comma. PV amount is the loan amount we have taken, starting with a sign of minus. I'm linking the sale where 1 lakh rupees is written. We have got the PV2, comma. Sir, FV is not there. Pressing 0 there. When it is a single transaction, this does not matter. Closing the bracket, type does not matter. Closing the bracket, pressing the enter, we have got 982.93. That's gonna be the interest payment from our side for the 12th period. Similarly, if I want to find the principal component of the 12th period, I would go there, and instead of IPMT, I would use PPMT, my friends. I hope everyone is doing it along with me. Rate as well, I am writing whatever the rate it would be. The rate is not 8%, it is 12%. I'm really sorry. It's 12. 1729 we have got here. Similarly, principal amount, PPMT, opening the bracket, rate is 12%, selecting that, comma. Per is the period. We want the principal component of the 12th period, right? So we would be writing 12. For which period we want the principal component, that we will be writing. If I would have said 6th period, you would have written 6 over there. Comma. NPR stands for the number of periods in totality, which is going to be 12, comma. Then, sir, PV we have got is 1 lakh, comma. FV would be having 0, comma. Type of, which will not matter, you may just write 0 or 1, whatever case be, closing the bracket, pressing enter. So principal repayment amount is going to be 144140. You may cross verify your answer by using the function called PMT. So PMT would be requiring first 12% rate, comma, number of periods 12, comma, PV would be minus 1, comma, FV would be 0. Type I am taking ordinary 0. So we have got 16143, which is nothing but the total of this two, which is interest and principal amount. So we have got the total of interest and principal amount as the PMT amount. So that means that our IPMT and PPMT amount are calculated properly. I'm doing it for the one more time, and then you people would be doing. First of all, we require here the compounding frequency is monthly. So that means we'll be making the installment payments on a monthly basis here in the loan. So we want the principal amount as well as the interest amount for the 22nd period. Right. So I'm starting it now along with you. So equal to first, we are finding the interest. So I'm writing IPMD. Then rate would be 12 divided by 12. Sir, why did you divide by 12? Because we have 12 months in a year. So the rate needs to be divided by 12, comma. PER. PER stands to be 22 because we want to find the interest amount for the 22nd period, right? Comma. Sir, number of periods in totality would be how many? There are 12 years. In 1 year, you have 12 months. So 144 NPER. And if you are also like me, you can just write it like 12 multiplied by 12. Let Excel do the calculation. No, why we are doing it? Excel is made for the ALSI people only. Pressing the comma. Let's move ahead. We have got the PV, which is going to be the amount of loan. Pressing the sign of minus, selecting that. FV would be 0. Taking the ordinary annuity, closing the bracket. I have got 927 rupees. I got 927 rupees as the interest amount. For PPMT, you would be doing, for principal, you will be doing PPMT, sorry, and then you will be cross-verifying the total by using the PMT. So giving you 2 minutes uninterrupted, to do for third and for the fourth one as well. So IPMT and PPMT are crystal clear to you. Giving you 2 minutes uninterrupted, please. Meanwhile, if you have any question or query, you can let me know. I hope everyone is doing it over there. And once it is done, you will just give the confirmation through the chat box. Expecting the active participation from the students once it is done. Some people will be like, abhi to shuru kiya hai, abhi se kya hai? Theek hai, 2 minutes. Let's see how many have done it. I hope everyone would be doing it along with me. और मैं तो करने वाला नहीं हूँ. मैं तो बहुत आलसी हूँ. आपसे भी ज़्यादा. आप ही कुछ करना. आप ही कुछ. हो जाए तो थोड़ा सा information दे देना box में. Good. So receive the confirmation from Ms. Emily. Nice to see. Others, I'm waiting for your confirmations, please. Mr. Daksh, Mr. Mitesh, Ms. Titli, Ms. Shreya, Mr. Jaydev, Mr. Dhruv and everyone. Okay, leave it. Now we'll do the second table and then you'll complete it by your own. So we have got the second table now where the frequency is given to us. We are supposed to find the cumulative principal and the interest amounts. That means if I give you for the first example, there are 12 years and we want to find that what will be the amount of principal I'll be paying in the initial 5 years in totality, and what will be the amount of interest I'll be paying in the initial 5 years in the totality. So here, instead of the IPMT or PPMT, we would be using the cumulative IPMT and cumulative PPMT. So cumulative would start with CUM. So you must be able to see CUM prints. Some prints function must be there. compress function is for the cumulative principal amount. So, sir, first one is the rate, the 12%, and sir, that's anyway yearly only, right? So, instruments are paid yearly, so no need to divide it anything, comma.
Hello.
Yes, yes, I can hear you. Yes.
Sir, your screen is not visible. It is from my end or what? I don't know.
Okay, my screen is visible to everyone or what?
Sir, Excel screen is not visible.
Excel screen is not visible. Okay. I have already shared it. And yeah, we can anyway, I'll okay, let me just go to, I'm just disconnecting it and joining it back. Is my screen visible now? Please, everyone, confirm it. Okay, good. Thank you so much. Thank you. You could have said that to me at the very initial stage itself. Anyway, you were wondering like there would be some internet connectivity issue from your side. That's why. fine. No worries. That kind of thing happens. So I had first completed this first table. I'm just giving the color to it. So it was more about identifying the individual interest amount and the individual principal amount belonging to the particular specific period. Once that is done, we will move to the cumulative amount, and for which we have got the second table. If you have already got some values there, you should be deleting those values. And here I have the first question that 12 years are given to me, 12% interest rate is given to me. 1 lakh rupees of loan as well. I want to know that in the initial 5 years, how much of principal amount would be paid in the loan and how much of interest amount would have been paid in the loan. So what I'm doing is equal to, let me use the magnifier so that you get it in a better way. So I'm there into a principal equal to compress. So compress is the principal, is the function to get the cumulative principal amounts. First one is the rate, 12%, comma. In the first case, it's the compounding on a yearly basis. So I'm not dividing it by anything, comma. Number of periods, sir, are going to be totality 12, comma. Then it comes the PV, comma. I'm just writing 1 lakhs over there. You can write it, you can link it as well, wherever we have inserted in the cell, comma. Now it asks you the start period. So for what period, for what specific period, my friends, you require the cumulative amounts. So I would say from the first, which is my starting period, comma, the end period. The end period will be 5 because I want the cumulative amounts for the first 5 periods. I could have taken from 2nd to 7th. I could have taken from 11th to 15th. So whatever the periods you want to take and you want to get the cumulative amount paid in those periods, you can start with those periods. We want from 1 to 5, so starting period as a 1, ending period as 5, comma, the type will be taken as 0. That will be the ordinary annuity, closing the bracket, just a second. Okay, friends, so you'll not be typing the sign of minus before 1 lakhs. It is showing us the error. Now, what could be the error? Why it is not accepting the sign of minus like we used to do in the other formulas? I'm not very aware about. But you shouldn't be using the sign of minus. So you get the principal amount for the initial 5 years, which is going to be 26,324. Similarly, if I want the cumulative interest amount, I would go cum IPMT. So cum IPMT, first one is going to be the rate, 12%, comma, number of periods are, sir, going to be 12, comma, the PV is 1 lakh rupees, not inserting the sign of minus, comma, starting period would be 1, closing period would be 5, and the type would be 0. Closing the bracket, I have got the interest payment for the initial 5 years. So my friend, you can say that interest payment is somewhere around twice of the loan repayment in the initial 5 years of your loan. Sir, hamara principal to sirf 26,000 ka deduct hua, lekin hamara interest to 54,000 tak ka deduct ho gaya. To hum शुरू के ईयर में ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट ही पे कर रहे हैं. सो व्हाट आई विल डू नाउ इज द टोटल ऑफ दिस टू शुड बी इक्वल टू द प्रिंस टू द पीएमटी अमाउंट्स ऑफ ऑल 5 इयर्स पुटिंग टुगेदर, राइट? सो आई एम यूजिंग द पीएमटी फंक्शन अगेन. रेट 12%, कॉमा, नंबर ऑफ पीरियड्स वुड बी 12, कॉमा, पीवी वुड बी 1 लाख, कॉमा, एफवी इज 0, टाइप वुड बी टेकन एज 0. Closing the bracket, pressing enter. So we have got the PMT for one period, right? Now, whatever the answer I have got, no, I'm just multiplying that by 5. So right in that formula itself, whatever the formula structure you have done, no, just put the sign of this fuderity. Some people are like, what is this fuderity? We tell the fuderity in the Gujarati language. This kind of scene you are able to see, that is called the fuderity. So multiplied by 5, so you get the cumulative amounts of PMT. Pressing the enter, so we have got 80,718, right? So basically that's going to be the total of these two, 80,718. You may check it over here. My mouse cursor is over there. 80,718. Right, so again the task for you guys there, 2 minutes uninterrupted, you are supposed to find the cumulative principal, interest and PMTs by taking these figures into account now. When the compounding frequency would be different, you would be dividing the number of periods in a year, and you will be dividing rate of return by the number of periods in a year, and you will be multiplying n by number of periods in a year. As simple as that. Let's see how many can do it. Maybe dheere 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 hadu 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 kar raha hun, kar raha hun, kar raha hun. Some people will be like, ekta kapoor aa gayi, teen baar bolte ho, meri marzi, mereko jo karna hai karu. Equal to cum prince, first one is the rate, gonna be 12%. In the same details we are doing it again and again and again and again, comma, number of periods are going to be, say if it is monthly and 12 number of years are there, so 12 multiplied by 12 gonna be my number of periods, right? I can straight away write 144 there. And if you are the elite level ALSI like me, then you can write 12 multiplied by 12 over there right in the formula, comma, PV gonna be 1 lakh. Starting period 1. Now I have asked the cumulative amounts for the first 22nd periods. I could have asked the cumulative amounts for any periods. I could say that from 23rd to 57, find me the cumulative amount. So starting period would be 27 and then 55 or whatever the case it would be. So this number of periods couldn't be any. And for all this number of periods, my friend, this principal amount and interest amount gets fluctuated, right? So for initial periods, it would be different from the upcoming periods. Okay, end would be 22, comma, type would be 0, ordinary annuity. If nothing is given to us, we assume it's an ordinary annuity. Kyunki ordinary ka to naam hi ordinary hai. Matlab ki wo extraordinary nahi hai. Closing the bracket. Aur minus ka sign kyun insert karte ho? Pehle batate ho, phir aap hi karte ho. Okay, nikal deta hoon. Sir, 12% should be divided by 12, no? Okay, pressing enter. So 7669, that's gonna be my cumulative principal amount. So IPMT cumulative would be same. 12% should be divided by 12 because rate needs to be converted on monthly basis. Number of periods would be 12 multiplied by 12. 1 lakh will remain same. Starting period would be 1 and the closing period would be 22. And the type would be will be 0 only. Pressing enter. So I have just copied the formula from above. Sir, agar aap monthly pe karte ho na, iska matlab kya hua malum hai? Ki aap pehle 22 period mein 21,000 ka interest pay karte ho. And against which you are just paying the 7,669 rupees of principal. So in the initial years, you are paying a lot of interests. That will happen. That's gonna be happen. And I must cross verify this, you know, by finding the PMT. So PMT equal to rate's gonna be 12% to be divided by 12. Comma. Some people would get this to expertise level of knowledge, you know, as far as the time value of money is concerned after completion of this lecture, because there is absolutely no variety remaining now. Each and every single kind of varieties have been considered into this. Then we have the number of periods in total, 12 multiplied by 12, comma. Sir, PV 1 lakh. If we to H nahi, putting 0, comma, type is going to be 0, comma, hamari adhuri kahani. We want to find the cumulative PMT, right? So total number of periods which have elapsed till now are 22. So I am multiplying whatever the amount I have got right in the formula, putting the sign of this fuderudi, multiplied by 22. We have got the cumulative PMT. Pressing enter. So, sir, this is nothing but the total of these two. You may cross verify that. 28,895. May I have the confirmation from all the students that you have got cumulative IPMT and cumulative principal amount? All of you, every one of you. Miss Hemali has already done it. She is working quite fast today. I must appreciate, and that too in this afternoon session. Mr. Mitesh too, Mr. Vishal too, amazing. Mr. Jaydev too, very nice. Mr. Daksh as well, okay. So today we have the dominance of the male gender in the chat box. Against Hemali, we have got 4 confirmation from my gender. Good to see that. Let's move ahead. मतलब लड़कियां दोपहर को ज्यादा सोती हैं, इसका हाइपोथेसिस ये निकलता है लड़कियां दोपहर को ज्यादा सोती है। ओके लेट्स मूव अहेड। यू वुड गो टू द CAGR फाइल, यू वुड बी एबल टू सी द CAGR ओवर देयर, जस्ट गो ओवर देयर। नाउ दैट इज स्लाइटली रिलेटेड टू द टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी ओनली रेट, वेयर दिस CAGR फंक्शन विल बी यूजफुल टू यू, आई एम जस्ट क्लेरिफाइंग दैट। ओके सो माय फ्रेंड्स, यू टेक एनी इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज, नो, सो सम ऑफ द इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज गिव्स यू द फिक्स्ड रिटर्न, लाइक यू इन्वेस्ट इन द फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट, दे विल गिव यू स्ट्रेट अवे 5-7%, 8% ऑफ द रिटर्न, राइट? दैट माइट बी कंपाउंडिंग ऑन वॉट एवर द कंपाउंडिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी वी हैव टेकन। सिमिलरली यू गो टू द डिबेंचर्स and you invest in the corporate bonds, you get the same percentage of the return or the rate of return which has been varying over a period of time, but you get the fixed return which has been decided. You take the government securities, you invest in the government bonds, say the sovereign gold bonds. In the sovereign gold bonds, you get the fixed percentage of the interest, somewhere around 2.5 to 3%. Now that is slightly off the track, but I would like to tell you that I am the great fan of this sovereign gold bond, huh? Because in that you have got the two types of returns. One is the increment in the market price as well. Another one is the fixed amount of return. So if you are generally investing in the physical gold, you know, at that point of time, you just get the increment in the market price. No one gives you the interest on the gold, right? It would be stored in your tijori or whatever the place you have kept. And the return you get is basically the increment in the market price. But in the sovereign gold bond, you can take the two types of returns. One is the fixed percentage of the interest you get, which is very, very, very moderate, very less, even lesser than the saving account rates, somewhere around 2.5% to 3% they give you. But sir, that is over and above the increase in market price of the gold. So basically, this sovereign gold bond will be moving in the same parallel lines of the prices of the gold. So right now, if you say investing in the SGB, it would be taking the price of today's gold and say after 10 years, you will be squaring off your position in the SGB, sovereign gold bonds. So the price of 10 years later would be taken for the calculation. So you get the two types of returns. But the problem with that, you know, the people right now investing in the gold are using the black money on which the income tax is not paid. But if you will be putting your money over there in a sovereign gold bonds, then you will not be able to get the read of this black money, you know. So that is a one loophole. Should not be called as a loophole. Ek to hamare paas black money hai aur usko utilize nahi kare, usko loophole kehte hain. बट अभी क्या करे, ब्लैक मनी है तो है, बहुत सारे लोगों के पास कैश में उनको परचेस करना होता है। बट देर आर सर्टन इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द फिक्स्ड रिटर्न इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज, यू नो, सम ऑफ द इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज गिव्स यू द इंक्रीमेंट इन मार्केट प्राइस। नाउ हाउ डू यू कम टू नो दैट व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट रेट ऑफ रिटर्न यू हैव गॉट फ्रॉम दिस, माय फ्रेंड? से यू हैड परचेस्ड वन शेयर इन 2002, say for example, of 180, and right now in 2022, say the price is 2000. So what is the rate of return you have got from this? How can you compare the performance of this with the performance of the fixed deposits or some of the other fixed return giving securities? Similar kind of the mechanism gets applied when you invest in the real estate, right? So if you purchase the real estate unit, the market price gets increased. So not every investment avenue gives you the fixed amount of return. Some of them just gives you the market price increment. So how do you come to know that what is the exact rate of return you have got from this? So that's why we use the CAGR, which is also called as the compounded annual growth rate, CAGR. The pen paper formula to find the CAGR is very simple: closing value minus opening value raised to 1 divided by n. N stands for the number of years. N would be number of years only, because we are giving it a name of CAGR, compounded annual growth rate. So N would be number of years, right? And then number of years, then you can write it in decimal as well, no? So some people will be like, sir, humne agar 5 saal aur 5 mahine mein kar diya, to 5 saal aur 5 mahine ko you will have to convert it into a decimal in number of years. So N would be in decimal at that time. Minus 1. So that would be the amount of your CAGR, compounded annual growth rate. That would be the rate of return that you would have got from this investment. So that is applicable to the real estate, that is applicable to the shares, that is applicable to every such securities which has the fluctuations in the market value. Over a long period of time, generally the upward fluctuation. Right, so let's go over there and let's take this example. Say you had invested in one share October 12, and you had invested at 402 rupees. So that's your cost price. And right now the similar share is available at 2341. So obviously 8 years have been elapsed between these two periods, right? So what is the amount of return, percentage of return you have got from this? So you may manually use the formula of CAGR over here. And if you have the advanced version of the Excel, you would have got the RRI function as well. So RRI function you can use. In some of the laptops, it might not be there if you do not have the 2016 or upper level versions. But if you have, you can use this. Otherwise, you may use the manual formula equal to. So what is the formula of the CAGR? Closing minus closing divided by opening, right? So closing is 2341 divided by opening 402. And I'm putting that in a bracket, right? And this is the sign of raise to. Elon Musk rocket, you know, which is going to the Mars. So that rocket sign is the raise to sign, power sign. And I'm again inserting a bracket so that it will get defined to that bracket only. In that bracket, we require 1 divided by n, right? So 1 divided by n would be 8 years, right? So I'm writing 8. Closing the bracket. And once you get this entire answer, you would be just having minus 1 at the end. So you have got some answer there in a decimal. Now, generally, you get it in a decimal like this, you know, but I have applied the percentage format over there already. So you would be getting the answer like this number. So 2464, 0.2464. So you can convert that further into a percentage. That is the CAGR given by that stock, you know. That's why I've been saying this to all, that the amount of return, my friends, you get in the stocks is just incomparable, unmatched, unparalleled with any of the investment avenues. Do you know what is the CAGR rate at which the market capitalization of the Reliance has increased since its inception? Somewhere around 34%. Can you tell me a one investment avenue which has given you 34% of the return? Is it possible in any other investment avenues? No. Now it has reached to its saturation level, you know. So now in upcoming years, you might not get this much of a return which you have got in the past, 24, 25, 30% of the CAGR rate. So now you should try to identify some small companies which have some great expansion scopes, you know, which can multiply their incomes and profits significantly by multifold. So that's the CAGR, and the RRI formula also gives you the same answer. So equal to RRI, opening the bracket. FUN is the number of periods, very simple to use. Number of periods are 8, comma. PV is going to be present value, which is the amount of investment, 402, comma. FV is going to be the amount of investment which is valuing right now 2341. Closing the bracket, you have got 2.63. So you can again convert that into a percentage. So you have got 24.64%. So is CAGR crystal clear to everyone? May I have the confirmation, please, from all the students? Compounded annual growth rate. Yes, Hemali. From that, you will be doing minus one. Your answer is perfectly correct. So whatever the formula you have applied, no, from that, you will have to just do minus one. Minus one. माइनस वन को तुम खा गई, माइनस वन को भूल जाओगी तो उसमें तेरा घाटा, माइनस वन का कुछ नहीं जाता. इज इट क्लियर? चाचा जी को भूल नहीं जाना है. ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड. ये माइनस वन है ना, वो कौन से है? वो चाचा जी है, वो जो मैरिज में आते नहीं है, वो ऐसे रूट के बैठ जाते हैं साइड में कोने में. मेरे को तो कोई भविष्य नहीं दे रहा, फियर ऑफ मिसिंग आउट, मेरी को तो कोई इज्जत ही नहीं करता है, मेरे को तो कुछ यही नहीं कर रहा है. वैसे जाके कोने में बैठ जाते ना वैसे वाले चाचा जी, उनको इग्नोर नहीं कर रहा, उनको साथ में ले लेना है, वरना आपका पूरा मैरिज फंक्शन बिगड़ जाएगा. लेट्स मूव अहेड. मे आई हैव द कंफर्मेशन फ्रॉम ऑल? इज इट क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू? गुड. One more function which is not a part of the syllabus but related to the time value of money, so I am covering that too. Please go to the F-week schedule. F-week schedule. So in F-week schedule, we have got one question. Miss Karina Kapoor has invested 15 lakhs in one variable interest rate option of fixed deposits. So some of the banks gives you the variable interest rate option as well. Now, those variable interest rate options are basically deriving from the repo rate, repo rates, you know, some spread based on the repo rates. So whatever the repo rates issued by the government of India on a bi-monthly basis, say 4% is there, and then they would give you the spread of say 2% or the repo rate. So it would be 6%. So on the very next period, if the repo rate gets changed to 5%, then you will get 5 plus 2, 2% spread is fixed. So you would get 7% interest on that fixed deposit. If the repo rate gets reduced to 3%, then you will get only 5% of return from it, right? So 3 plus 2 would be 5. So anyway, I have taken the different rate of interest right now for the different periods. Now, till now, whatever the questions we were solving for the future values, now if you want to find the future value after so and so number of periods, we were assuming that the rate of return expectations remains same constant over a period of time. But sir, what if that rate of return expectation gets changed? Say for the first year we have got 9, then for second year we have got 9.5, then for the third year we have got 10, whatever the interest rate would be, you know. So for that we may use the F-week schedule formula instead of F-V. So I'm going over there in the FV equal to, then I'm using FV over there, FV schedule, sorry. The first thing you will be writing over there is the principal amount, which is going to be 15 lakhs, right? So I'm writing 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, comma. Then in a schedule, which is the second option, I would give the range of all the interest rates I have got for all this number of periods, starting from the first to the last one. So I'm selecting B6 to B10, closing the bracket, pressing enter. So the fund value after 5 years with this variable interest rate option would be 24,15,515. So when you are using it, when you will be using it, when you have the different interest rates for the different periods. Now say if it would be quarterly frequency, you know, then number of this period would be representing the quarters. So 5 years must be multiplied by 4. So you will be writing 20 periods over there, and quarterly interest rate you will have to write. So there are certain investment avenues like Sukanya Samriddhi account, which is specifically promoted by the government of India for the girl child education and the marriage. they generally issue the rates on a quarterly basis. Since last few years, they have started issuing the rates on a yearly basis. They are not changing on a quarterly basis, but in the earlier years, they were changing the rates on a quarterly basis. Similarly, if you take the national savings certificates, public provident fund, in which generally the people invest for the long period of time, they also change their rates on a quarterly basis. Earlier, they used to change the on a quarterly basis, but since last few years, they have kept the fixed percentage of rate on a yearly basis. So if such kind of investment avenue is there, you will be converting your number of periods into the quarters first, and accordingly, the rate of interest will also be taking the quarterly rate of interest for all the periods. And the same mechanism you can apply and find the FX schedule. Is it clear? May I have the confirmation from all the students, please? FX schedule, where to use it, crystal clear? Good, thank you so much. Now, some people would be wondering that, sir, you have taken the different FE amounts over here. Now, this will not happen, just cancel it. That was a different function actually. Data table and data analysis, which we'll explore in upcoming few more sessions. Let me not serve everything right at this moment, you know, otherwise you will start vomiting. No matter how beautiful, how wonderful, how tasty the sweets would be, if there would be an overflow, then it would always be a vomiting, you know. So let's not do the overflow of these things right now. We'll explore it gradually over a period of time. Fine. So that's it from my side as far as the time value of money is concerned. In the next session, my friends, we would be exploring the sources of finance, their cost of capital, the weighted average cost of the capital. And the best thing about this syllabus is that at the end of the module, we would be having the application of those theoretical concepts by using the Excel or other softwares, right? So you can do the good amount, good application and good analytics only if you have the good conceptual understanding. So next session, we'll be moving to the second module, the sources of finance and the cost of finance. Bye-bye, take care. That's it from my side. Sayonara. If you have any question or queries, you can let me know. Please put your enrollment number as a mark of your attendance. See you all in the next session. Expecting your attendance, the maximum attendance with the utmost enthusiasm and energy in the next session. Bye-bye, take care.